direct from the studios of Channel E, the Something Special with special guest star David Obers and a special appearance by Quorum and the E-Tone Players. But first...
You open the door.
He didn't say open the door. He said come in.
You could have hurt yourself.
Oh, no, I couldn't. I used my head.
Your head?
Yeah, that used my best punch.
Okay, calm down.
I'll get a fix now.
Sit down. Have some water.
Please, this is not a gymnasium.
Who are you?
A doctor.
Oh, you're not going to stop the fight, are you? He didn't hurt me. He didn't even lay a glove on me.
No. Calm down. I'm Dr. Dermis, a plastic surgeon.
Oh, like it's still on the door.
On the floor. Well, what can I do for you?
Well, I got my face all smashed up in a fight and...
Done!
Boy, a flock of them flew over that time.
Didn't see anything.
Well, they fly pretty fast, don't they?
You must have seen more hallucinations.
Well, they look like bats to me.
Well, what did you want done to your face?
Well, I want to look handsome. I'm going to go into show business.
Oh, you're going to be an actor.
Why, no, I'm going to be a singer. Raindrops keep falling on my head.
I see, Mr.
McPug. But I'm going to get that change when I go into show business.
Oh, and what are you going to call yourself?
Elvis Presley.
Well, I don't know if the world's ready for another Elvis Presley, but let's get over to the and start on plastic surgery.
Well, I hope you can make me look like Lee Majors. I want to play a joke on Farrah Fawcett.
Well, I'm sure this machine will make you look quite handsome. Duck! Another flock of birds, eh?
No, those are the same ones. They must have forgotten something.
Well, just step in here.
Well, what is this?
Oh, well, it's the latest medical miracle, a painless operation designed to perform instant plastic surgery. This machine is guaranteed to perfect your features.
Well, what if it doesn't work?
Oh, well, in that case, your old face will be cheerfully refunded.
Oh.
Now,
Well, what's this?
Oh, well, this is a medicated mask designed to shrink facial tissues. Now, I'll put this over your head and please come into the machine. Now, I'll regulate these dials to take a little off the ears, a couple, 2-3 inches off the nose, and some of the excess facial tissue under the eyes.
Oh, if you have any left over, could you make me a brother? I get kind of lonesome living alone.
Ah, the surgery is complete. We'll have you out in a second.
Thanks.
I feel handsomer already.
Thank you. None of the following are illusions of trick photography. All tricks are performed by David Oberg, the master of magic. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. David Oberg.
Hi, my name is David, and I'm going to do some magic for you. These are two guests who we have up here today, which have nothing to do with the act. They are just strictly nice people who have decided to help us. This is Bob, and this is Adam. Fine. Adam, would you do me a favor? Take a look at that little bottle. Climb inside, look around, see if there's any trap doors, hidden mirrors, or anything of that nature. Don't break the bottle.
Looks okay.
Looks okay to you. Bob, would you take a look at it for me? Okay.
Yeah, it's okay.
Watch closely now. There you go. Two little magical genies. A mama genie and a papa genie. That's enough with the bottle. What I'm going to do is take the mama genie and put her in my hand. Would you open your hand for me? We will put the papa... No, that's just backwards. I'm sorry. We take the papa genie and put him in my hand. We take the mama genie and put her in your hand. Would you close your hand, squeeze tight, hang on to her? But at the count of three, they're going to change places. Okay? One, two, three. Did you see them change?
No.
Did you?
No.
You didn't see them change either. Let's try it again. One, two, three. Did you see him change that time?
No, not that time.
Either. You missed it again, huh?
Missed it.
Well, it appears as though mine has changed, but it's also disappeared. Oh, there it is. Thank you. Alrighty. What I'd like you to do for me is take a look at the cards, examine them, make sure that they're a normal, everyday pack of cards. Okay?
Yeah.
Alright. Normal. I'm going to need your help, Adam, and I will need your help, Bob. Adam, what I'd like you to do is to say stop while I'm ruffling through the cards. Anytime today.
Stop.
While I'm going through the pack.
Stop.
You stop me at the Four of Spades, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, would you take a look at the card immediately under the Four of Spades? Don't show it to me. Show it to the people at home.
We don't have the people at home now.
Put the card back in the pack. Put the cards back in the pack anywhere you want. Right there. Okay. Would you like to shuffle the cards? Any time today.
There you go.
52 pickup. That's very good, Adam. Remind me not to let you shuffle the cards again. Let's just look through here real fast. Tell me to stop at your card. No, it's another trick. Don't worry about it. There are many different types of shuffles. I asked you to shuffle the cards, right?
Yeah.
And you chose the first grade slosh. That's not exactly a recognized shuffle in Vegas. There are a couple of better ones, like the Russian shuffle, where the cards go rushing from hand to hand. Rush hand. Then there's your basic Channel E media service shuffle. And then, of course, there's the more advanced Channel E shuffle. No, really, all serious aside. Then there is what is known as the mixing up of the cards. Now, to mix up cards, that really takes a lot of talent. To mix up cards, you take the top, turn it to the bottom to the inside to the outside to the inside, the backs to the fronts, and the fronts to the backs. So basically what you get is a couple of cards that are backs to fronts, a couple that are fronts to backs, and even a few that are backs to backs. Now, what I would like you to do is to just blow on the cards. No, not spit blow. There's quite a difference. Watch closely. One, two, three. Did you see what I did?
Oh, yeah.
That's right. I just went like that.
Yeah.
It's really quite simple. But in that one split second, I managed to straighten out the entire pack. I seem to have missed a card. What was your card?
Ten of clubs.
Ten of clubs. Bob, you're not doing too much right at the moment, so what I'd like you to do is to cut the cards for me.
Yeah.
Okay. That's very good. You realize, of course, you could have cut the cards anywhere you wanted to. You happened to cut the cards right there. This is not a forced trick, right? You could have cut them higher, a little bit lower. You happened to cut them right there,
you
correct?
You told me to cut them. Yeah.
Well, that's where you kicked them.
You told me to
Everybody's a comedian. Okay, this is the card that you cut at, the Five of Hearts. Would you take a look at that card, but don't show it to me? Okay, put it back in the pack anywhere you want. That's very good. Would you like to shuffle the cards? This, I gotta see. Anytime today. That's very good. Obviously, you can tell he does hang around the media room.
And half the tablecloth.
All right. Adam, what I would like you to do is give me a number between 1 and 10, any number you want.
8.
You sure you want that number?
That's
you sure you don't maybe
ten.
Want 4? No, you want 8.
Yeah.
Well, it's got to be difficult. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, wouldn't it be amazing if the 8th card was indeed your card?
That would be amazing.
That would be very amazing. Just like that.
No.
That wasn't the card?
No.
You're sure?
No, yeah.
You're positive?
That was the card you
And this out. Is the master of magic, Mr. David. No.
Was that the card?
Try again.
That was the card you cut at.
Wait, just 1 second. What was the card?
The...
The 9 of spades. I'm sorry, well, that's okay. We always keep an extra one, just in case I miss. A coin trick. 2, 4, 6 coins. $6.50. What I'm going to do is take 1, 2, put 3 in that hand. Would you take those 3 and put them in this hand? 1 at a time. 1, 2, 3. 3 in this hand, 3 in that hand. Watch closely. 1, 2, 3. Did you see what happened?
You went 1, 2, 3.
That's very observant of you. But a little bit more than that happened. One of the coins happened to jump from one spot to the other spot. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. Do you want to try that again?
No, but maybe you should.
Okay. 1, 2, 3. 4 in that hand. Almost. Those 2 would you put in that hand? 1, 2. 2 in this hand, 4 in that hand. Watch closely. 1, 2, 3. Did you see it go that time?
No.
You missed it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1. One last time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 coins in that hand. Bob, would you open your hand for a second? Would you hang on to those 5 for us, just like that?
Yeah.
That's fine. Adam.
Yeah.
Keep your eye on the 6th coin. The 6th coin is always the hardest coin because it's the last coin. But concentrate, and we will cause the coin to penetrate right through his hand. 1, 2, 3. Did you see it go?
No.
Well, it did. Would you open your hand? You want to count the coins?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
6 coins. Thank you. Now for the last trick. I will cause this coin... one coin, right before your very eyes, to penetrate right through the table. You may say that seems quite unbelievable, but
that
it really
seems
isn't.
Quite unbelievable.
I'm glad you said that. But I will in no way touch this coin. Now, to prevent me from touching the coin, I will cover it with this little shot glass. Would you take a look at the shot glass, please? Yes.
Okay.
Would you take a look at the coin? Do you want to take a look at the table? No. No, don't walk off with the coin. Typical media service. We cover the coin with the shot glass. Now I will cause the coin to penetrate right through the table. Right here on television. Watch closely now. Oh, there's one catch. I don't want you to see how this amazing miracle is done. So would everybody please close your eyes for 1 minute? No, I didn't think so. He closed his eyes now. That's why I've brought with these little handkerchiefs. We will cloths. We cover the glass with the cloths. There you go. There's 1. There's 2. And now...
Are you screwed into the table?
No, not quite. Now we will cause this coin to penetrate right through the table. Watch and see if you don't see it go. 1, 2, 3. Did you see it go?
No.
You didn't. That's because it didn't go. Let's try this one more time. At the count of 3, the coin will penetrate right through the table. You watching?
Yeah.
Okay, watch closely. 1, 2, 3. Did you see it go?
No, I didn't see it.
Yes, it has penetrated right through the table.
Sure.
And now, for something even more amazing than that, the coin will come back up through the table and under the glass. At the count of 3 now. 1, 2, 3. Yes, it has gone. No. They didn't like that too much. Well, let's try it one more time. Once again, the coin will penetrate right through the table. One, two. Oops. I'm sorry. I made a mistake. It isn't the coin that goes through the table. It's the glass.
Shows are available for ages 9 to 90. For information, call David at 931-8368. That's 931-8368.
To.
Oh, come on. Put it on. Okay, you're at a party. Where's my gift? Did you get me one?
No, he forgot.
Well, that's not important. Here's a riddle. I'm the president. My mom's name is Dumbo. Now, what am I?
I have no idea. What are you?
I'm Ella Fitzgerald. Get it? Ella Fitzgerald. I made that one up myself.
You should have guessed that one. You should have gotten that one.
You want to smell my flower?
No. All right. Hey!
Your friend's face is all wet.
Of course it's all wet. He just squirted water all over me.
Oh, now it makes sense.
Hey, come on. You can't go around squirting people in the face.
I certainly can. I just did it to your friend. I can do anything I want once you set your mind to it. Do you agree?
Yeah, I guess I do.
Okay, let's shake on it. Aha, gotcha. Seventh one today.
Now, see here.
Did you give me this monkey?
No, of course not.
Well, then I'll have to thank you for it.
Jesus, I can't believe this.
All right, I'd like to apologize. You guys have been really terrific sports. Now, have you ever watched a television show, Can a Camera?
Yes,
we do. You mean this is a trick? We're on television?
Hey.
That's right, and I'm Alan Funt.
You're not Alan Funt.
Well, you're no Ron Fleming. You don't see me complaining.
See here.
Okay, here's your part. I'll start first. I hear music, but there's no one there. Okay, this is your part. I smell blossom, but there's no one there.
I smell blossoms, but the trees are bare.
And you call yourself a singer? Allow me to introduce myself. Here's my card.
Viola Bushwhacker, RN. What's the RN for? Registered nurse?
No, raccoon needles. I sell raccoon needles.
Wait a minute. Raccoons don't have needles.
Oh, no wonder business is so bad.
Come on, you're bothering us.
Really, just leave us alone, all right? We don't want to be annoyed.
Well, let me ask you one question. Does this annoy you? Woo-hoo!
That annoys me.
Well, it annoys me, too. So we have a lot in common.
Hey, we have absolutely nothing in common, all right? We're just all waiting here for a bus.
Why are you waiting here for a bus?
It happens to be a bus stop.
Well, in that case, I'll just have to take my time someplace else. Oh, I almost forgot Harvey. Would you mind standing up? Come on, Harvey. Come on.
For joining us for this first edition of the Something Special. This has been a production of the television class at Beverly Hills High School. Stay tuned later in the year for the second edition of the Something Special. Good night.